name of this song is Cosmik Debris.
Affairs and devote his attention to me, but I said, look here, brother, I just can't go for what you say. Well, I've been on the street since Tuesday. Now why don't you just go away? And ram it up your snout. But I've got a crystal ball, he said, and held it to the light. So I snatched it all away from him, and I showed him how to do it right. I got the newspaper round my head, so I looked like I was deep. I said some mumbo jumbos then. I told him he was going to sleep. I robbed his rings and pocket watch and everything else I found. I had that sucker hypnotized. He couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him his future then, as long as he was hanging around. I said, the price of meat has just gone up and your old lady has just gone down. Look here, brother. Diving with that cosmic debris. Don't spread that stuff around San Francisco, but don't you waste none of your time on me.
Thank you. forget the big M.
Potato pie. Yeah.
What? Grown out in your backyard unless you're ready to bake them on Saturday night. Why? I don't know what I'm talking about. I know what you're talking about.
Sick. I want to tell you, Duke.
What's all these sway dudes doing in the group? That's what I want to know. Shit.
Problem. My personal nigga got a problem.
Yeah.
I didn't hear you say that when you was eating that sweet potato pie.
Kiss my
You can kiss my
tomorrow. I know you're just waiting to go down to the Mars floor. You ain't got to tell me.
You want some more rust on the floor?
You know what I'm talking about, right?
All I know is, George, when you had those boogers in your room, you didn't sound like that the next day on stage. I believe you've been doing something interesting this afternoon, George. Well, was it good, George?
Lord have mercy.
It must have been really good, George.
You know what he told us? He said, don't you come knocking on my door for 3 days.
I don't want to see you. You know what's bad when George Duke goes incognito?
I don't know about this rock and roll. You know, I come from the jazz world. You know, I don't be downbeat and shit like that.
Yes, George knows all about those groups that get formed and disappear with their extensions waving in the moonlight, and a career in jazz can be yours too. We're offering tonight, one night only, scholarships to the Westminster College of Jazz in Salt Lake City, Utah. The curriculum includes 4 jam sessions a day during which not one note is played inside of the key indicated at the beginning of the tune, making it possible for even the most illiterate horn player to sit in and sound like he was heavy and happening. Just to give you an idea of what we're talking about, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to simulate a Westminster College advanced bebop jam session for you right here on stage right now. Our avant-garde tendencies will extend themselves into the realm of Charles Ives type fantasy, where we will use the simplistic blues roots. This moronic sort of vamp that we're playing right now, we'll keep that going and superimpose on top of it not one, not two, not three, but 4 completely unrelated jazz standards happening right before your very eyes, conflicting and stomping all over each other's little dick right here on stage. Bruce Fowler will play his own version of Ornithology on trombone, while Walt Fowler plays, let's see, what can you play? Giant Steps on the trumpet. And you can play Little Coquette on the saxophone. And Don Preston can play Sweet Leilani on the synthesizer all at the same time. Let's hear it for jazz. Take it away. Said so many times before, and I'll say it again because I liked it. Take it away. Really take it away. Take that jazz away. Now wait a minute. You can't expect to play that kind of music in Washington, D.C. What with all of these FBI people and CIA people and security guards and politicians and cab drivers trying to rip you off and all those kind of people. You can't be playing that kind of music in this town. Bullet. You can't play that kind of music in this town and expect to get any pussy. Oh, well, there's some now. I want you all to remember one thing. Remember the basic reason that you entered the field of rock and roll, the reason you crossed that tender little borderline from jazz into reality. There is only one reason for you to be on stage here tonight, all you fantastic horn players, and that is to get some grunt after the show so that you can sound like George Duke tomorrow night. But wait just a minute. Enough of this fooling around. Let's get down to business with something that I'm sure each and every one of you can understand. The reason you can understand this is because it's been available for you to listen to for almost 10 years now. We're going to play some selections from the Freak Out album. Anybody in this audience that knows the words, sing right along. Checking it out, baby. I checked it out a couple of times. Oh, darling, it's important that you believe me. Bop, 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 that it can't happen here. Could imagine that they would freak out somewhere in Kansas. Kansas. Could imagine that they would freak out in Minnesota. That they would freak out in Washington, D.C.
AC/DC, pop, pop, pop. AC/DC, pop, pop, pop. AC/DC, pop, pop, pop. AC/DC, pop, pop, pop.
Wait a minute. I remember, I remember, I remember, they had a swimming pool. I remember, I remember, I remember, they had a swimming pool. And they thought it couldn't happen here.
Randa Canada, Canada, Randa Canada, Randa Canada, Randa Canada, Randa Canada. They thought it couldn't happen, but
Susie.
Yes.
Susie Cream Cheese.
What is it?
This is the voice of your conscience, honey. I just want to check one thing out with you. Susie, Susie Cream Cheese, my darling, what's got into you?
America, walk on by the schools that do not teach. Mr. America, walk on by the minds that won't be reached. Mr. America, try to hide the ignorance that you inside. You're so mild, you I'm sorry,
And well they should. But us regular folks who might wear an occasional tennis shoe or a python boot know this exquisite little inconvenience by the name of
stank butt.
How true that is. You know, my python boot was too tight. I couldn't get it off last night. A week went by, and now it's July. I finally got that sucker off, and my girlfriend cried.
You got stink foot. Stink foot diet. Your stink foot
puts the hurt on my nose.
Stink foot, stink foot.
I ain't lying. Can you rinse it off? Do you suppose? Help me out, Bruce. Here, Fido. Here, Fido. Bring the slippers, little puppy. Yes, that's a good dog. Fire, fire, fire.
Thank you.
much enough of that. The name of the next song is Inca Roads. It's a song about flying saucers, and George will sing it to you. Do what? Say that again, Brian.
I've written on the ground.
Ooh, flip your ground switch. Any better?
Yes.
Wonderful. I'm out of sight. He said for a nominal service charge, I could reach Nirvana tonight. If I was ready, willing, and able to pay him his regular fee, why, he would drop all the rest of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me. But I said,
look here, brother. Who you driving with that kind of Look here, brother.
Don't you waste your time on me. The mystery man got nervous and he fidgeted around a bit. He reached in the pocket of his mystery robe and he whipped out a shaving kit. Now I thought it was a razor and a can of foaming goo. But he told me right then when the top popped open, there was nothing his box won't do. With the oil of Aphrodite and the dust of the Grand Wazoo. He said, you might not believe this, Corey. This will cure your hangover too. And I said, hey.
Look here, brother. You jiving with that
cosmic debris. Now what kind of a guru are you anyway? Come on, tell me.
Look here, brother.
Don't you waste your time on the bully.
Please don't, I'm getting married.
Let's be all bound down. Be just pumping every one of them up and all the back. Illinois, come on, man. Boom, 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 boom. The Illinois in my bandit. I heard it on the news.
He just might wanna pump.
Sergeant Buzzard Rusty, go ahead, rump.
That he just might wanna pump.
Sergeant Buzzard Rusty, go ahead, rump.
That he just might wanna. And the judge would say,
no poo-poo joke.
And they'll drag in the bandit for all to see, saying, don't nobody know sympathy. Hot soapy water in the first degree. And the bandit might say,
why is everybody always kicking out?
Well, damn you, come. Another girl
It must be just what they all need. It must be just what they all need. It must be just what they all need.
Too much college education.
Turn the mic up.
Explain, since at first it was
everything that's ever been broke at her. Thank you.
Hello, GIs.
Off with a copy of Rolling Stone. Easy.
it gets great. I know she was easy, easy, easy baby. Easy, easy, easy baby. Easy, easy, easy baby. Easy, 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 easy. I just had to take the girl to my house. Easy.
Thank you and good night.
Is the responsible party for the enwitment of the original potion. Through the magic of stagecraft, we be able to see him at wake. He now be preparing some ugly shit to make your life even more miserable than it already are, since this batch be resigned to render him immortal. We does not know if it wine wick yet, but we can always hope for the best. Lies all green and buzzing in his dungeon of despair. Prisoners grumbling, his day clothes, scratch day matted hair. A tiny light from a window hole 100 yards away. It's all day ever. Gets to know about the regular life in the day. And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking, and weeping greenish drops. In the room where the giant fire puff the waking, and the torchum never stop. The torchum never stop. Go now, do look. Rocks, rats, and snot, and vomit on the floor. Half a dozen ugly zombies, boy, popping through the laboratory door. Knives and spikes, and guns, and the like of every tool of iron. And a sinister midget with a bucket and a mop. Where the blood go down the drain. And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking and weeping greenish drops. In the room where the giant fire puff awakened, and the torchum never stops. The torchum never stops. The torchum. The torchum. The torture never stops. Go on, Doula. Play that little guitar one more again. Oh, I smell trouble. He be messing with pig meat here. Motherfucker be rejecting some halina directly into the duodenum of the unsuspecting victim. Now he gonna see if he immune to it by eating it at himself. Lies all green and buzzing in his dungeon of despair. A evil prince keeps a steaming pig in a chamber right near there. He eats the snouts and the trotter's face. The loins and the groins is sonorous voice. His carving style in well rehearsed. Shout all main because all main because all main because all main because and disagree. Well, no one does. the best of coast of all New West. Some wrong been done, he done it for his. And it's been so bad, his bones been choking. He's been greenish drops in the pad of a Lucalagna. These ugly suckers. Boy, when white folks come back from being dead, they sure get scary looking. But don't take their appearance too seriously, Tiba, cause they say this is the sort of folks that belongs on Broadway.
Somewhere over there, I can tell, there's a voice of a potato-headed, whatchamacallit, who does not wish me well. Clothes are quite stupid, and also his shoes. He's got a big old duck mouth, who knows how he chews. He thinks he knows something about the great plan, how ultimate blandness must rule. He knows not a drop, not a crumb, not a whit of the reason for doing this criminal shit. And then if he did, would it matter a bit? Not at all, because it is red. Our beige blandish God tends to certify. Only the boring and bland shall survive. Only the lamest of lameness will thrive. Take it or leave it, you won't be alive if you are overtly creative. Fairies and faggots and queers are creative. All the best music on Broadway is native. Who will step forward and end all this trouble for beige blandish citizens clutching the rubble of vanishing dreams of wimpish amusement replaced by a rash of creative confusement? Soon, my brave zombies, you'll make your return. Broadway will glow, Broadway will burn, along with the remnants of everything new. My holy disease will do wonders for you. Those lovely producers who paid for you then will do it again and again and again. The spying potato with horrible diction will rot in the garbage when this show's eviction takes place shortly after my alternate skill of theatrical sabotage triumphs your will. I've a special review I've been saving for years for a show just like this, with potatoes and queers. I'll say it's disgusting, atrocious, and dull. I'll say it makes boils inside of your skull. I'll say it's the worst of the year. No wind down the plane and it's hard on your ear. I'll say it's the work of an infantile mind. I'll say that it's tasteless and that you will find a better excuse to spend money or time at a Tupperware party. So do be a smartie. Hold on to that dollar a little while longer.
for spending it here. Why, it couldn't be wronger. What happened to Broadway? Where's it gone, all the glitter? The heart and the soul, the platter, the bitter. And after this deadly review hits the paper, then will come Roper, Bender, and Rafer to legally execute all that remains of this tragic amusement for drug addled brains.
Lies all green and buzzing in his dungeon of despair. All of them zombies, Daddy fucking went down there. Are they crazy? Are they seen it? Are they stagecraft? Someone painted. It has never been explained since the place it was created. But a musical like we's in require a whole bunch of everything. We're talking everything that ever been. Look at her.